Now, when looking at areas of regions, okay, one thinks of the of double integrals, right? Because you have this relation that area is equal to area of a region R is equal to the double integral over the region R, okay? So you have this sort of relation that was discussed previously. And so your mind thinks about double integrals. Well, Green's theorem converts a double integral, or you could express a double integral in terms of a line integral. Okay? So you could now, thanks to Green's theorem, use line integrals to compute areas. Okay? And that's what we'll do thanks to Green's theorem. Notice we needed one in there. And so any vector field such that the curl, the 2D curl equals 1, and of course we're using the circulation form of Green's theorem here. So as long as the curl, the 2D curl equals 1, we'll get this result, that the line integral around the closed curve C is equal to the double integral, where R is bounded by C, C is the boundary of R, is equal to the area of R. And that's how you could compute an area using a line integral, okay? Now, we needed the 2D curl to be equal to 1. Now, there are many, many, many ways to do that, okay? There's many ways to respect that relation right there. Some simple and obvious ones is choosing the vector field F is equal to 0 and X and the Y component that you see here, or choosing this vector field, or even choosing this vector field. All of these vector fields have a 2D curl of 1, and a line integral of any of them will give you the area of R, okay, thanks to Green's theorem, all right? This expression here is a little more democratic because it uses x and both x and y, but any of these expressions will work, okay? And here, of course, we're expressing this is actually a line integral, okay? This is actually equal to, it's just a different symbol for line integrals. And so let's compute the area of an ellipse. The ellipse with a semi-major axis, or one axis equal having being of length 2a and the other being of length 2b. Okay? Now if you want to use a double integral to do this, it's actually quite complicated and not that simple. Let's instead trade this double integral for a line integral around the curve C. What vector field do we choose? Well, I chose this vector field F. Why did I choose that vector field? Well, only because I know its 2D curl is 1. Okay, so I'm gonna take the line integral of this vector field around C, and I know at the end that my area will be equal to the area of my region, which is an ellipse over here. Okay, so of course, we need a parameterization of the ellipse. Here is a parameterization of that curve C of the ellipse with t being between 0 and 2 pi. And now let's compute that line integral. I'll use this notation because you just might see it, even though I don't really favor that notation. Dx, don't forget, is not your simple calc 2-1. It's actually equal to x prime, the derivative of the x component of the parameterization times dt. So let's compute the derivative of the x component with respect to t. We get this. Let's compute the derivative of the y component, and you get this. And now you'll plug in your parameterization into your vector field. So wherever you see a x, now it's x of t. And this dy is y prime dt. This dx is x prime dt. And wherever you see a y, now it's a y of t. So you do that straightforward. So you plug, say, this one here and y prime dt here, and you get this, okay? And you could do the same thing with that expression, and you end up with an integral over dt from 0 to pi. You compute and you get pi ab, which you just used a vector line integral to compute an area, which is really cool.